Okay, now part about STM32CubeMX. About the install, you are received the complete package for motor control session, but if we upgrade the new CubeMX tool, you can found in this website, in ST website, and the packages for micros for families. Be careful, the CubeMX needed to Java to the properly working. The CubeMX support those IDE, Atolic True Studio and System Workbench are free for STM32. IR and KL are free, and for the debugging you need the ST-Link drivers in your PC. You can find in this website, and also you can find in receive package, and for installing you need the admin rights. If you use the alone the STM32CubeMX, this is the main window, and how to use and how to work with STM32CubeMX. In the repository, it's all code, all functions, everything. And in the, through the IDE is generated through the repository to your project. This is the ideology of CubeMX. Be careful with the placing of repository for motor control, because the part of STM32 workbench use the CubeMX, but in the path of repository needs to backslash for the properly working. If you don't add to the repository, sometimes happen that you haven't got in the path, you can see some errors during the generation in motor control workbench. And you can check in updater setting, which is the slash is in the after repository. And in the repository, you can found all packages which was downloaded and all codes you will see in the cube is IDE, and you for full work you need the packages for families. In repository you can found your downloaded packages, and also in the install new libraries in the next slide you can check which libraries you downloaded, and you can check whether families are updated. What is inside the CubeMX IDE? You can find the MCU selector, pinout configuration, clock tree, peripherals and middlewares, power consumption, calculator, and the main code grid generation. As I mentioned, inside the pinout wizard, clock tree wizard, peripherals wizard, and middlewares, and for computing of consumption of micro. Inside the CubeMX is light version of STMCU Finder. When you click to the new, you can select through the peripheral choice and whatever proper micro you can sort by series, package, and etc. And when you select the micro, you can switch to the pinout, and in the pinout you can select pinout for peripheral or manually. Manually, I mean that you click the right button mouse and see the list which function pin supports, or you can select the periphery and automatically add the pin. Also in the top you can see the middleware, the support middleware. At this moment the motor control library is not part of CubeMX. The library is generated by the motor control workbench, help with the CubeMX. which is integrated to the in the motor control workbench. In the future, version 6 will be integrated fully to the STM32CubeMX. When you see that the peripherals are green, you can the pinout is assignment. The yellow it's only for ADC. It's the means that you can use, but some restriction because ADC has a single mode and differential mode. And when you occupy some pins of differential mode, the pins, the ADCs are yellow. And the red is that the signalization that you're not able to use. All pins are occupied by other peripheral or use for other function. This is about the function, not now, the keep user placement. When you select the R2C, which is defaulted, ported to PA1415, also occupy the SVD, which is in the PA15. It's for serious communication for debug. It's important. And when you select the R2C, and after that, you can see that the pin assigned to this, and after that, select the serial valves, automatically change the pinout from R2C and select the clock for SVD, SDIO. But when you select the keep current signals, you are not able to enable the debug. Be careful for keep current signals placement. Please unselect, and you can after you can able to turn off the system the serial valve for debug. And how to change the pinout configuration? You can use control and click to the pin, and after that you can see the pinout which support this function. It's a very useful function. For example, when you're porting micro from 32 pin to 48 pin, you can change only the right click, control and click, and see the next pin which is support and move. Yeah. The next is the clock configuration. It's a nice tree. The function of this tree is view the frequencies which is used and dividers, and also we can automatically calculate the frequencies. When you set the I want maximum, for example, 180 megahertz, automatically the dividers are set it to the proper value. The next is the configuration, where you can see the used middlewares and all peripheries. When is the green plus, the peripheries not configured, for example, DMA. When you see the green, it's okay, but when you see the red cross, you have to go to the peripheral and see what is the wrong and etc. In the left, you can see the used IPs, but only for the view, not impact to the middleware. When you open the used middlewares, you can see the, for example, interrupts, GPIO and DMA, and inside the parameters, you can set your requirements, for example, protocols and etc. And in the NVIC folder, you can see and add the DMA for the periphery which you use, and if you need the mode, and which is to peripheral to memory, data byte, and the next. The important is also the NVIC panel. Here you can see the interrupt table with the possible used function, and when you check, you can enable, and after that you can use in the code. And also we can set the priority and sub-priority. The same for configuration of DMA panel, you can set your requirements for DMA, and again the GPIO panel for all peripherals which are used. We will use, for example, XT13, and we have to change the GPIO mode. We will see in the upper example. The last one is power consumption calculator. You can compute the consumption of micro. For example, the door locker, you can compute the energy which is used for the opening and for the sleep. And after, you can calculate the battery, the capacity of battery you will need. The last one is the generation of code. The CubeMX generate the code. And in the top, you can see the first is the main function, like system configuration, start thread, and the peripherals in it. And after that follows the main. This is all generated by the CubeMX. Be careful for updater. When we generate code in the STM motor control SDK, sometimes you can see that in the background is open the window with the cube updater. You can click to OK. Our recommendation is set the manual check for updater setting and refreshment to no auto refreshment. That's about the updater. For project setting, you can set the project name, but is when you use the CubeMX, the motor control workbench, which is generate the code for motor control, is automatically filled. And in the toolchain ID also is filled from the workbench. And in this project setting, you can see the firmware library which is used. And the next is a code generator. There is settings how to generate the code, and it's very useful because you can generate the pairs of C.C and .H, or you can generate inside the main. I will show you in the next slide. The first step is the firm library package. You can select that you want to use all libraries, and from Q repository is copy to your project all functions, all C code for the selected micro. It's good for the movable project computer by computer, because you have all libraries inside the one folder. The next, save the space, is you can copy only necessary, which is used. And the last one, also the reduce the data in the computer, you can use only the link to the repository. It's a not good way for the movable project, computer by computer, because repository can be in the different folder, and also in the for developing in your computer. Generate files with this configuration is the MX peripherals are generated to the main. When you click to the generate peripherals in installation as a pair, the peripherals are generated to the separate C code. And this is the useful function, because when you click to the generate, you can lose your work, your code. But when you click to the backup, to previous generated file, the cube generate the new code or actual or regenerate, but the previous version is saved to the backup folder. This is very important part. Please use only this part for your code, user code, because when you wrote the code and click to the generate, you lose everything what is not inside the brackets. This configuration must be selected in the generated file. But when you unselect and regenerate, you lose the code inside the brackets. These areas are in main C, in interrupts, and HAL MSP, which is configured the NVIC GPIO for the periphery. And you can use for variables, function, and etc. The next is the delete previous generated files when not the regenerate. It means that the regenerate your project the CubeMX, delete the periphery which is not used. And for better power consumption, you can use the all pins are switched to the analog, which is pins not used. But be careful when you not set the system serial wire for debug and set the all pins are free, you lose chance to debug the micro. Before this, you have to select the serial wire. And generate to the CubeMX in it, and as I mentioned, debug feature. And for debugging, it's useful full assert. It's a function which call it when is the unknown function, like use the pin 17, and after that, when you put the breakpoint, you can found what is the and which line is problematic. And now about the HAL package, HAL package. The HAL package you can download from the ST website, and this package use CubeMX to generate the code. And inside this package is the abstract layer embedded software, now and low layer software, and some middlewares like RTOS, USB, and etc. This is the ideology of HAL and HAL. We have the different hardware drivers, but the layer in the top should be the same for the all devices. Also, we have the examples, as I mentioned, middlewares and board demonstration. I will show you in the next slides. And the package organization, when you download from ST website the package contains documents, drivers, middlewares, project and utilities. In the documents you can find how to start with the F3 and some application nodes. In the utilities you can find mainly for the graphics and for the audio, like pictures and etc. In the drivers, so you can find the CMCs from the ARM Cortex. In the HAL library, you can find the code for peripheral. And in BSP, it's a board supported package. Inside is the code for example, gyroscope, accelerometer, some codecs, which is in the ST Evolution board or the Discovery board. In the middlewares, we have the middlewares, which is developed by ST. It's STMV in library for USB audio, and third party, which is for FATFET FS, library for JPEG, and for crypto and free RTOS. At this moment, the motor controller library is not included in this part. In this part will be in the version 6, I believe. Now it's separately in the motor control workbench. And in the project, you can find the prepared example for each evolution board, Discovery board, etc. And it's inside is templates, examples, which is examples means it's for peripherals, GPIO, USART, etc. And application, it's a more complex code, which is contain the USB motor control, for example, 6-step sensorless. And the demonstration, it's a full code for mainly for the Discovery and for Evolution board, which is more complex application. And again, the organization of downloaded package, you can see in the drivers is BSP, CMCs, and HAL drivers. In the middleware also the ST and third party, which is related to the function, and prepared project for evolution boards from ST and utilities like PC software for USAR communication. Now it's about the examples. As you know, we have the HAL and low layer library, and also we have the examples for HAL, for low layer, and mixed examples where is the HAL and low layer part. I mentioned you can see that this is for low layer example. It's the same structure, but when you click to the drivers, you can see that used library is a low layer, not HAL. And the difference between Cube and HAL library and STD library is that the porting between the families. It's useful to use the same code and port to the another. The micro, the STD library was for F0, F3 and F4, but the HAL library now is a full portfolio of STM32. And you can easily move micro to micro with the same middlewares and application code. Only you can change the periphery and etc. Therefore, the new library used for the HAL. Now the concept is that you have the F4 family, which is derivate some micros, and you can use in the same package, you can use the same API layer. This is the about the C coding and how to work with the HAL library. It's document. Were found documentation, and the main part is the generated structure. You can see the inside the source code is user part, interrupt part, and the same is for the includes files .h user code and interrupt part. The HAL drivers. This is all. It's for HAL C and derivated function for peripheral. And you can see that the HAL config is for part of HAL drivers and part of user code. You can add the user code to the HAL underscore config. And the third part is CMC's library, where is the startup, NVIC vectors, enumerating for flash, external flash, and it's linked. It's the H files is linked together. And in the structure, you can see the HAL library, the drivers are there, and for the CMCs in the driver CMCs, the same for the startup. In the HAL MSP, it's a part of HAL drivers, the CubeMX generate the HAL MSP, and also you can add the user code to HAL MSP, where is the initialization of GPIO and DMA. And in the main, it's initialization of all, and the third is interrupt, where is the also the generate, the basic generate from the cube, but you have to add the user code to the callback. Yeah, it's describing what is in the CMCs, in the startup for the STM32. Now is example for F4 and the interrupt vector table. And you can see that this name is used in the code. It's in the interrupt. Also in the startup is a reset interrupt handler, and the first call it system init, and after it's jump to the main. The ideology of all is that the use USART periphery, and inside the use the function which is the same for the one family. For example, for the SPI, you have the in the reference manual you have two SPR periphery, and in the HAL HAL library you can found the HAL SPI.c, which is the inside of all the functions. The same is for USART and etc. And the system periphery for the config and XT is not dedicated inside the HAL HAL drivers, because they are in the strictly managed in the whole HAL. Again, the hardware abstraction layer you can use the same API layer for different families, and you can easily port micro by micro. Here is the three possibilities how is handle the differences between micro. You can see that the if def, where is the part number of micro, and select the, for example, flash bytes, option bytes for the proper for the product. And also the next is for the product family, where is set the not the same for all, but you can get the for example clock. This is the case 2, and the last one is the use the new module, where is the also if define, and you can select to the symbol inside the IDE and use the proper settings. The HAL contains the HAL configuration. You can see that the IPs which is used, the CubeMX automatically delete the slash when you use the proper when you use the periphery. And also inside the configuration is values for HSI, HAE, and for the VDD voltage. Ideology, HAL libraries use callbacks from interrupts, and you can found the proper interrupts in the periphery. For example, now you can see the HAL X6, for example, for SPI, and use in the interrupts routine. Here is the flow how HAL library initialize the function. The first the HAL start initialization, after that initialize the GPIO DMA and enable clock for periphery, initialize the initialize periphery, and after that go back to the code. When you use the HAL function, you can get this callbacks, this returns value. If it's everything okay, you can get the whole okay. It sometimes happen you can get busy, error, or timeout. It depends on periphery, and you can found in the description of function. It's about the initialization, and inside the HAL MSP init, you can see that the NVIC is set it to the priority, and GPIO NVIC. In the CubeMX, in the NVIC configuration, you can select it and enable the, for example, system timer. And in the code, you will see that the priority is set to group 4, and the SysTick is set to the values which is filled in the CubeMX. This is the part inside the MSP init, which is for the user code. You can see that this is generated from the CubeMX, and also you can add your code for initialization. inside the HAL library, you can found the function for the initialization, for getting HAL delay we will use in the app examples, and HAL initTick is for the system tick. And now about the low layers drivers. The ST developed low layer drivers because we haven't got the next actualization for SPL, standard PF library. Therefore, ST developed the low layer, which is for the deeply to the code. Go to deeply to the code, and we add to the HL and to low layer together, which is cooperate inside the code. And now we can see the topology. The low layer drivers is inside the also drivers. We add the low layer examples, HL and LL examples, and it's in the deep to the code, to the register programming. This picture nice describe where is the low layer drivers. Now we had the HL library, and the low layer is in the down. And again, you can see the comparison between standard peripheral library and low layer library and HL library. The standard peripheral library is a wide range, and when we use HL library and low layer library, the range is it's higher than with the standard peripheral library. You can recognize that how you can recognize that you are used the HL library after the name of the STM32, for example F3_LL. This is the libraries for which is based on the low layer drivers. And the differences between HL and low layer, the HL is very easy to use, but sometimes happen that you have to go to the deeply to the code. After that, you can use the low layer, which is sometimes in the same level like the register programming, the faster, but it's difficult to write the code and orate it with the low layer. Sometimes you can open the examples for the same periphery with for HL and for low layer and see that the low layer is it's long than the code is long than for HL, but low layer it's for time critical operation it's better than HL. For example, inside the configurate GPIO you can see that the function start with the LL_GPIO. When you use the HL, the function starts with HL_. This is the difference in the code, how to found.